Hi there, Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand. We're going to talk about short-chain fatty acids, what they are, and also some of the best foods that help to stimulate the production of short-chain fatty acids. So these are basically acids that are produced by the fermentation of particular foods in the intestine. And these fatty acids provide really good fuel for the colonic cells. They help to build up the health. They also stimulate cells that help to produce T cells or immune cells. So it's very important to have good levels of short-chain fatty acids in your gut, because that means you've got great gut health, which means you've got great overall health and well-being. So let's look at some of the best food sources, short-chain fatty acid food sources. So resistant starches is the first one. So these starches really resist breakdown. They break down very slowly and ferment very slowly in the gut over a prolonged period of time, giving you a lot of energy. We're talking about whole grain cereals like barley, brown rice, lentils, green bananas. Remember, I've always talked about green bananas, not the yellow bananas. Cooked and cooled potatoes. Sweet potatoes can do this as well. And many people can't tolerate these foods. They tell me, Eric, I feel sick when I eat them. I get bloated and gassy. And do a stool test, folks. If you can't tolerate these foods, especially if it's quick after eating, you might want to do a SIBO, a breath test, to determine if you've got upper GI bacteria. And you may also want to complement that by doing a comprehensive stool test, you know, along with this breath test, to determine the whole GI tract microbial health. It's a very good idea to do. So these are great foods. Brown rice is one of my favorites. Brown rice and quinoa combined is very nice to eat. Lentils are good too. And the green bananas cooked in coconut milk, what a fantastic food. So that's number one, the resistant starches. Number two is pectin. And I'm always talking about these foods too. Berries and apples. Green apples are my favorite. Apricots, blackberries, carrots, oranges, and apples. They contain pectin. So pectin is a kind of starch also that breaks down more slowly over time, feeding, you know, the cells lining the small bowel and the large bowel. The third one is called FOS, or fructooligosaccharides. Now, some supplement companies actually put this inside capsules with probiotics, which I'm not a fan of at all. I've had too many people complaining or aggravations when I used to make that recommendation. And for that reason, in my Canzito Restore product, you will find no FOS in there. So FOS and inulin, two types of sugars, are found quite a lot in foods like Jerusalem artichokes, onions, leeks, and wheat, and rye, and asparagus. So if you don't want to eat the gluten, avoid the wheat. But asparagus are a fantastic food. Green beans also contain some amount of FOS in them. Onions in particular are very, very good. Red onions and brown onions. So let me read that list again. Jerusalem artichokes, but don't eat too many or they become fartichokes, remember? Onions, leeks, rye and asparagus. And if you want, some organic wheat is also quite good. The other one you could look at, number four, is from a tree called the larch tree, larch arabinogalactans. So these are called a mannogalactan, I think, a particular type of sugar that really helps to feed up different aspects of your gut. So this will help to feed up parts of the small bowel and the large bowel. It's a great food for the short-chain fatty acid, is larch. It's particularly good for immune dysfunction like sore throat. They can also be used for autoimmune diseases and even cancer treatment. It's very, very good. So that's larch, arabinogalactan. And the fifth one is guar gum, which is a thickening agent found. Guar gum comes from particular types of beans, I think, that they dry and they make a powder out of. So guar gum, if eaten in too large amount, can cause a lot of problems in the gut. Very small amounts are quite beneficial. But again, I've seen some people who buy tubs of guar gum and have tablespoons per day and get more bloating and more gas, thinking it's a die-off effect. So don't eat guar gum or large arabinogalactans in large amounts. You just need small amounts of these regularly. So those are the five food sources, best food sources for short-chain fatty acid production. Thanks for tuning in. If you haven't got my little report, the Candida report, please click on the link below in the description box and you can grab it. Thank you.